again. Today we're going to talk about tables. How are tables made accessible and how it behaves when it's used with a screen reader and how it behaves when it's not accessible with a screen reader. So today we have, again, on the left-hand side, we have tables that are not accessible, and on the right-hand side, we have tables that are accessible. So the first one is an example of
table with 6 rows and 3 columns letter grade. Out of table no caption slash summary and header cells example.
It's called no caption summary
header cells
and header cells. So this table has does not have a caption and it doesn't have any headers. The cool thing about having headers is that when you're using the screen reader and you're navigating with the arrow keys, that it will detect those headers, the column headers, and it would read those. So that means you don't have to keep track of which column you're in. So in this case, we have
6 rows and 3 columns, grading scale. Letter grade.
Letter grade.
Grading scale.
Grading scale.
By points.
By points.
Grading scale.
Grading scale.
Percentage.
By percentage. So if I hit down arrow to go to the next row, we get the letter grade A.
200 to 225 plus.
And we get the points.
9100%.
The percentage. And again, it goes down to the next row. But this is only 3 columns. So imagine if we had 20 columns and trying to track each title or each name of the column. There was no way. And this is what's happening here. So, for example, here's
180, 201.
So I don't know what title of this column is,
89%.
Or this one. So let's switch to the other side, and we'll navigate a table that's accessible, but with the same data.
Accessible tables, heading level 1.
Okay.
Heading level 2 with caption slash summary and header cells example.
So this one, again, one thing I forgot to mention is that these have captions. And having the captions in the table is really nice for us to know what kind of content we're going to be coming across.
Table with 6 rows and 3 columns, letter grade. Total grade percentages and their corresponding letter grade.
And here's the caption. So in having the ability to navigate in the web by single letters, so in this case I press the letter T, it announces the caption at the table of what the data is in the table. So that's what that caption does, so that we don't have
letter
to figure out what it might be. So here it is.
Scale. Letter grade.
So letter grade.
Grading scale.
Grading scale by points.
Grading scale by percentage.
Grading scale by percentage. Now,
A.
Here's A. I'm going to hit down arrow.
Grading scale by points 200 to 225 plus.
As you can hear, it reads the column header, and it reads the data information in the cell. Let's go to the next one.
Grading scale by percentage 9100%.
So it reads the column header, and it reads the cell information. So we're going to go down to the next row.
B.
This is B.
Grading scale by points 180 to 201.
So again, it reads the points, but it reads the column header.
Grading scale by percentage 89%.
Again, the percentages.
C.
Now C, we're down to the next row.
Grading scale by points 157-179.
And that's the by points.
Grading scale by percentage 70-79%.
So again, imagine if we had a big old table, 20 columns and 20 rows, and we were in the middle of it and we wanted to know where we were. This is a great example of an accessible table.
Grading scale by,
so I can just hit Alt Control down arrow.
F, edge of tape, edge of tape,
so here's F.
Gradings F.
I can just
D, gradings F.
I know that's F. I can hit down arrow.
Grading scale by points less 134.
Right? So it tells me that.
Grading scale by percentage less 59%.
And it tells me when the percentage for the grade F. So that is awesome. I like that. So now let's visit another situation, another scenario of inaccessible tables.
Table with 6 rows and 3 table with 6 rows and 3 columns. Out of table empty cells example.
So this one is called empty cells example. So many times what happens is that there'll be data displayed on the table, but there's a lot of white space, so a lot of just empty cells. So sometimes for us using the screen reader, it can be kind of a hassle because that means we're traveling from cell to cell and it'll say column blank, column blank, column blank. Let's see.
Table with 6 rows and for lesson activity. WK1, introduction, Tuesday, reading journals and introduce yourself, blank, blank, Thursday, class discussion, WK, history of what Tuesday, reading, blank, blank.
So you can hear the
blank, blank,
blank,
blank,
blank. So again, with a large table, you would be hearing blank, 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 blank. especially if you don't know if the tables are not tagged correctly. So there's no headers on the columns. So that means you have to go way up.
Double blank, edge of table, edge of table.
So I'm hitting Alt Control Up Arrow to go to the first column.
Edge of table, blank, WK, blank, WK1.
So this one says WK1, which is supposed to be K week 1, but we changed it in the next example, which I'll show you in a second.
Lesson.
And his lesson.
Edge of table, introduction, blank, history of photography, blank, college, edge of
so,
table,
so I'm just traveling
blank,
with the
lesson, edge of table, lesson.
Alt Control Up and Down Arrow. Just imagine again a big table. And so it'd just be a hassle. So let's go to the good one over here.
Accessible tables heading level 1. With caption slash summary and header cells exam table with 6 rows and 3 columns total grade per merged empty cells example heading level 2.
So merged empty cells. So this is the table I was just showing, the one that there's a bunch of blank columns. Avoids that by merging those columns. So that way we don't have to navigate or travel as much.
Table with 4 rows and 3 columns, class schedule, week, lesson, activity, lesson, week, class schedule.
So the class schedule is the caption.
Week.
Week is the first column.
Lesson.
Then lesson, the second column.
Activity.
An activity. So now we're gonna go to the next row.
Week 1.
Is week 1.
Lesson introduction.
Is introduction. So as you heard, it said lesson and then introduction. So it's reading the column header and then introduction, which is what the information in this cell.
Activity bullet Tuesday. Reading journals and introduce yourself.
And his activity. So what's happening on that day and then happening on Tuesday. So we're going to go down to the next one.
Bullet Thursday, class discussion.
And then Thursday, and it says class discussion.
Week 2.
So now we're going to go to the week 2.
Lesson history of photography.
So it's lesson. So again, it's reading us the column header and then what it is about. So photography.
Activity bullet Tuesday, reading week 2 lecture.
Activity, which is the next column over, and it's reading, that's the name of the header.
Bullet Thursday, class discussion.
And then Thursday.
Week 3.
Then week 3.
Lesson college closed, holiday.
Telling us the lesson. Again, the header, and it's telling us that that day is closed because it's a holiday.
Out of table heading level 2 complex table example.
And that's it.
Table with week
so as you can see, just by navigating with the arrow key, the down arrow key, and having those headers being labeled properly, it allows us to navigate just by hitting down the arrow. We don't even have to use the navigation keys. So it makes it a lot easier for us. So I hope that gives you an insight, again, how essential it is to make tables accessible. Thank you.